Particularly, I hope for another 100-1 winner here in this Gold Cup. Unlikely.
Lord Windermere was a good one as
Lord
well.
Lord Windermere, yeah, absolutely. Go on, what price is Mike Bite here?
Mike Bite is a 3-1 favourite. You guys all seem to fancy Mike Bite. Well, actually, maybe not you, Paul, but do you think 3-1 is one of the best priced favourites of the week? I mean, I think we very much like our Duke and sizing John, actually, in this one.
But yeah, I'm in the Mike Bite camp at the moment, certainly. Yeah. And I've long been in the sizing John fan club, and I think it's between the two of them. Obviously, he's got to come back from a disappointing run, but you know, he was awesome last year, and his first run at Punchestown this year was fabulous as well, when he destroyed Jack Adam. And clearly he came out too quick the last day. Imperial Commander came back from a desperate run into King George to win a Gold Cup. It can be done. I don't think it's, you know, with Jessica Harrington, I think she'll get him there in peak form again. And it was good to see Robbie Power commit to him as early as he did. But Might Bite is the coming horse. The Gold Cup invariably is about the coming force, and that's him. He obviously has his quirks. But if you look back at last year's race, I mean, to do what he did and still come home, he bossed the race throughout. And despite what he did up the hill, he still got home in front. He jumps, he travels, he's a really good horse. And if it wasn't for that quirk, and they'll ride him accordingly, you know, I mean, Nico de Bonneville knows by now what's coming. He'll be prepared. If it wasn't for that quirk, he'd surely be evens. So, I mean, 3-1 has to be a good price. I mean, if Native River shouldn't be good enough, Our Duke is coming the whole time, but again, he has a lot to prove. Road to Respect is an improver, but he still has an awful long way to step up. Kill Ulta Vic has run 3 times over fences. He's fallen or nearly fallen twice. Couldn't be having him in a Gold Cup. It's Might Bite is the one to beat, but for me, it's him and Sizing John are the two class horses.
Patrick, you've kind of marked your card already here, because you said Might Bite's the horse you'd most like to ride outside. But what about Kill Ulta Vic anyway? How has he been?
Yeah, well, Might Bite as well, you'd enjoy riding him because there's a bit of a
challenge
there, yeah, as well, isn't there? So, he didn't blow anyone away in the King George, but I think they went quite steady in that race. They all finished quite close together. Whereas in Cheltenham, when he was in the RSA, he obviously went a huge gallop. You know, they were so well strung out. And I think this will be a fascinating race, because obviously Mike Bite needs a strong gallop. Native River won't hang around. Our Duke won't be hanging around an Irish National winner. And then you're going to have these horses coming from behind, like Sizing John, who has that bit of class and speed. And a completely forgotten horse. Again, one bad run. I mean, this horse won, what, 6 races last year? Won the Grade One, John Durkin, and then runs one bad race, and suddenly he's...
Yeah.
Last year was a bad race, and he's not good enough. And I mean, for me, he's hugely overpriced. Kill Ulta Vic, you know, he's had the injury, but he has that engine. He beat Thistle Kraken in Grade One Novice Hurdle at Punchdown. And his jumping, it's a big ask with his jumping. You know, he has very little experience.
It's not that he's a bad jumper. Sure, it's not. It's just circumstances. Three runs coming into a race like this, it's not ideal. Like, sure.
Exactly. It's the cards you're dealt. You know, I think if he'd had a normal novice season and everything, he'd be fine. But Coney Green did it. I think Don Run had 4 runs. Like, it's not impossible. And he has the engine to win the Gold Cup, but it's going to be a big, big ask. Total Recall, for me, his form at Whisper puts him a long way behind this, but he's improving all the time. And again, a real strong gallop is going to suit him. I think Jack Adam is...
Won't you get a spin on Jack Adam?
It's not impossible. I got to ride him the last day, and it was, yeah, you know, he's a great spin. It's like PlayStation jumping. You just press X, come to the fence, and it just sails over it. And although Ruby says, sometimes when you need him, like the second last in the World Cup last year and the last in the Punchdown World Cup, he can get it wrong. But I think he's overpriced. This race always throws up horses that place year after year.
Yeah, and big prices.
You know, he handles the track and the way the race can be run. Now, I don't think he's been in his best form this year. I mean, I was a little disappointed with him in Leopardstown, to be honest. I just thought he was beaten very quickly off the home bend. But maybe we'll ride him a little differently. And I just think he's probably overpriced.
Paul, who do you think is the most likely? This is a cracking race.
Well, yeah, it's a cracking race. I think it's wide open. I mean, I'd be laying, you know, I'd have been laying all the evens you could get, Mike, but if he was that short. If somebody had told you that a length win from Double Shuffle would make you Gold Cup favourite at the start of the season,
when you look at the way he...
Town, wouldn't you? Double Shuffle hit about 10 fences that day as well, remember? I mean, it was, you know, I still think Mike Bate might be the most talented, but you've got to remember, he's run 4 times at Cheltenham and he's wandered around 3 of them. Mm. Like, you know what I mean? And he's almost nailed on to do that again. And if he does that again in a finish, I don't see him winning the race easy, put it that way. Like, no, something, there'll be horses a lot closer than Whisper was last year, and there's extra distance for him to go to. So that would worry me. I think Size and John is probably the best if he comes back. But I just like this young, improving profile, and I think Road Respect at more than twice the price of Mike Bright is that he's the one that does it for me. He's won at the track last year, so we know he handles the track. Mm. He would actually have landed on his side if he didn't have horses on the inside of it, but at the first fence in the Brown Advisory last year. But other than that, he's just done really, really well. Surprised me this year. And the one who might sneak into a price at absolutely massive odds, and one that Patrick hasn't mentioned, but I just think it's Batchison as sneaked in under the radar. I think he could be very, very talented, and he ran in the Albert Bartlett a couple of years ago, and he skipped round there, travelled in really, really well. So, although he didn't get home that day, he was only a five-year-old, I think, and he's probably a bit stronger now. But obviously, it's a big ask. He's only won a couple of listed races at Tramore. But
it's a huge ask. Tramore again.
Well, though, isn't
it? Yeah, he had. I think some chap fell off him at the last that day in the Albert Bartlett.
Would it be fair to, if the owners didn't have Undersaw, would he more than likely be a
He has that, he has that option still, and he's won down in Thurles and Tramore, down the country. But as you say, he's done it fantastically well, and he's like Footpad. He's improved hugely for going fencing, and he doesn't look like your stereotypical chaser. He's quite small, quite slight, but he has the heart and scope to jump. And as you say, he's that young potential improver. So I couldn't put anyone off him. He's in great form at home.
Gav, who do you like in this?
Very, very open race. I've actually had a small each way bet on Backson at 50-1, so I don't think he's totally out of it. People keep talking about Might Bite being an up and coming star. He's actually nine years old.
Yeah, he is.
It's amazing sometimes with the ages of horses compared to their profile. He probably should be 7 from 7, except for falling at Kempton last year. One thing about the course this year compared to the RSA, the old course is closer to the Guinness tent. the new course for the Gold Cup is 50 yards further in, so he probably won't get to know about the gate.
That's an interesting one.
It's further away, so it might be out of his mind.
Give him another 50 yards to run sideways.
There'll be a railing in the way, perhaps, but Nicky de Boinville definitely went too soon in the King George. What he was doing kicking on before the bend seemed a bit strange.
I disagree with you there because they obviously gone very slow, and he's a horse that needs a strong gallop. No.
Yeah, I suppose he just idles a lot, doesn't he? He idles obviously in the.
I think that's what it comes down to ultimately. They're talking about the other horses getting closer to him. I don't think he does a lot. When you look at what he does in his races, sometimes when he hits the front, he clearly is a bit of a dosser, and that's basically what it came down to.
York Hill was York Hill, he was a bit of a dosser in front too. So maybe he's like that he doesn't win by very far. I'd say if they came at him again, he'd probably go again. I think that Size and John has got a massive chance last year. The time of the race in the Gold Cup last year was actually quite quick, so it was a decent event. The one horse I cannot believe the price is Native River. Oh, he's 5-1. I can't believe he should be twice that. I'll definitely lay him to win the race and to be placed. He's a decent horse. He needs soft ground. If it come up really soft, like a few years ago it did one year, he'd have a chance. But on decent ground, I could see 5 or 6 of them travelling very well at the bend. I think it could be a fantastic finish.
Right, go on, one word there, or one word or one name. Could be two words, it might bite. But go on, one for the Gold Cup.
It'd be Roads of Respect for me.
Patrick?
Might Bite.
Arjake?
Richie?
Reluctantly, I'm going to go Might Bite. I think Size and John is the best horse in the race, but in current circumstances, Might Bite.
Gav?
I keep changing my mind in this race, but at the moment, I'd say Size and John.
Good stuff. Okie doke. We do have one or two questions coming in, by the way. A lot of questions coming into you about Ruby, but not sure you could answer. But because he's been out,
these questions are going to be able to answer.
This is slightly more conceptual. Because he's been out for so long, will it be more difficult for him to pick and choose his rides? As in, like, because he literally hasn't sat in quite a few of the horses in over the course of the season.
I don't think so. He's been on the ground at home a lot, and he's seen the work, and he's seen how they're working. He's talking to the jockeys, and I actually think I was on the ground there for a while as well. I think you nearly see as much. Being on the ground, and you can watch all the work as opposed to just the only bit of work you're in. I don't think that'll affect him. And this happened to him before. Didn't he only come back riding the weekend before he won Champion Hurdle Hurricane Fly 1 year?
Mm-hmm. 1 year he did,
so it didn't affect him that year anyway.
Yeah, it won't affect him.
No.
And he'll have first call.